This week on Imperfect Paradise, co-founder of Black Lives Matter, Patrice Cullors, on what she thinks is at stake in this year's presidential election.
I understand the moment she is up against.
Listen to Imperfect Paradise wherever you get your podcasts.
LAist and Show and Tell present an evening with David Sedaris. The writer, humorist, and radio contributor will take the stage Saturday, November 16th at the United Theater on Broadway. Tickets and information at laist.com/events.
Today on the LA Report, a lot fewer shows are being filmed around these parts. Some landlords are getting sued for discriminating against people with Section 8 vouchers.
It's no surprise that sorts of income discrimination is rampant.
And you want to go to the House of Mouse anytime soon? How much is it worth to you? Good morning. It's Thursday, October 10th. I'm Austin Cross, and you're listening to the LA Report from LAist 89.3. Scripted film and TV production in LA is down, dropped significantly last year, according to a report out of Film L.A. We are talking about a nearly 20% decline last year compared to 2022. Big reason for the drop? More competition. California's been losing market share to other states like Georgia, New York, and other countries like the UK and Canada. Some places might offer financial incentives to attract producers. Now, LA is still the world's top TV producer, but the report notes that more shows are being produced in multiple locations. Long Beach officials, meanwhile, are warning residents to avoid drinking or cooking with tap water. Officials found a major water main break in the California Heights neighborhood yesterday. That prompted officials to issue a boil water notice for residents north of Signal Hill up to Artesia Boulevard. Residents should boil that water for at least a minute before they use it to cook, drink, or brush teeth. Long Beach utilities will update residents when the tap water is safe to use. A housing nonprofit has filed a discrimination complaint against more than 200 California landlords, saying they illegally denied housing to people with Section 8 rental assistance. A 2019 law bans discriminating against tenants who use housing vouchers, but when the nonprofit Housing Rights Initiative deployed a group of investigators to pose as renters with Section 8, many brokers and landlords said they would not accept the voucher. David Smith is a lawyer with the Inner City Law Center who's repping that nonprofit.
As the housing market has become tighter and the housing supply has become scarcer, it's no surprise that sorts of income discrimination is rampant.
Those complaints name major real estate companies like Coldwell Banker and Sotheby's International Realty. LAist has reached out to those companies for comment. You know, there's all kinds of health info on TikTok. Some of it's helpful, a lot of it's bogus. Now the World Health Org is fighting the misinformation by getting doctors to create their own videos, including ones here in SoCal. Caitlin Hernandez reports.
Dr. Willow Jenkins is a child psychiatrist in L.A. and San Diego. She's also a TikTok influencer.
Your mind and your body are connected, and your emotional states can affect your physical symptoms and your physical body.
Now she's been tapped for the partnership to provide fact-based info about mental health.
It's something that sometimes can be difficult to get reliable and evidence-based information about, so that's the biggest reason I'm on the platform.
Her past videos have racked up millions of views with topics like childhood anxiety and kids' tablet use. Now her work will go global. For LAist, I'm Caitlin Hernandez.
Coming up, how much would you pay to go to Disneyland? Think of that number and stick around.
This week on Imperfect Paradise, artist and co-founder of Black Lives Matter, Patrice Cullors, on what she thinks is at stake in this year's presidential election.
Kamala Harris has been put into a seat that is incredibly historic, not just because she may be the first Black woman president.
And she reflects on the current state of the Black Lives Matter movement.
What happens when the community actually moves to the center or the right of the conversation?
Patrice Cullors on Imperfect Paradise, wherever you get your podcasts.
LAist and Show and Tell present an evening with David Sedaris. The humorist, comedian, author, and radio contributor will take the stage at the United Theater on Broadway to share insights, read from both published and unpublished work, and host a live Q&A with the audience, followed by a book signing. It's Saturday, November 16th at the United Theater. Tickets and information at laist.com/events.
Back now with the LA Report. I'm Austin Cross. You want to go to the House of Mouse sometime soon? Well, you might have to cut back on some bare necessities to do it. Yeah, Disneyland is getting even more expensive. The company raised ticket prices 6% yesterday and between 6 to 20% on annual passes. Customers will now have to pay $206 for a single day ticket during peak season. The silver lining of all that, parking rates have stayed the same. I guess that's good. And don't forget, kid tickets for one day, now $50 for the next few months. A Silver Lake landmark just got a historic upgrade. The LA City Council named Astro Family Diner a historic monument, citing its unique architecture. It was built back in 1959, and it is a prime example of the googie space age modernist style. Well, foggy mornings have been the norm across SoCal this week. McKenna Sievertson explains what's behind our cloudy start to the day.
We're used to seeing this weather for May gray and June gloom. And although it fits in with spooky season, the fog isn't typical for this time of year. A long period of high pressure and lack of Santa Ana winds is partly to blame. The fog will generally start to thin out when the sun starts shining, but once evening rolls in, the marine layer will start to move inland again. These conditions can change your visibility quite quickly, so be extra careful when you're out early on the roads. Keep the speed low and your fog lights on. For LAist, I'm McKenna Sievertson.
Yeah, like she said, cool, cloudy conditions this morning in the Southland. That's going to burn off later. Look for temperatures in the low 80s in the LA Basin, mid-80s for the valleys, upper 80s for inland areas, low 70s for your beaches. Hey, thanks for listening to the LA Report. I'm Austin Cross. You can read more about the stories you heard here on our website, LAist.com. For local news anytime, go ahead and add LAist 89.3 to your favorites on the dial or download the LAist app. You can catch me on the airwaves on Morning Edition, weekdays from 5 to 9, and on Air Talk Friday, where we always have a good time. And you can find me on Instagram at Austin Crosstalk. Drop by. Say hi. LA Report AM Edition is hosted and produced by me, Austin Cross, with assistance from producer Jillian Moran Perez. Our engineer is Federico Garcia Rodriguez. Catherine Mailhouse is the director of content development. LAist's executive editor is Megan Garvey. Original music by Scott Kelly. Check back here at 4 for the PM Edition. You know, listeners like you help make LA Report possible. Please, if you can, step up, donate at laist.com/join. The LA Report is supported by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe quality journalism makes Southern California a better place to live. And I think so, too.
LAist consistently delivers important news to Los Angeles and Orange County.
Hi, I'm Jill Replogle, the Orange County correspondent at LAist. The fire that broke out in Tustin last November at a World War II-era military hangar spewed asbestos into the surrounding community. For months, neighbors had crews in hazmat suits combing their front and backyards to safely remove debris. When I couldn't get a straight answer on just how far and where the toxic material had spread, I requested public documents, and we produced the only publicly available map that tracked reports of how far the debris had spread. About 10 miles from where the massive hangar burned for weeks.
LAist, connecting you to your community.